We have two patron saints in Catalunya. Saint George and Montserrat. Tomorrow, you will go to the Montserrat mountain. You will see the Black Madonna of Montserrat, who is the patron saint in Catalunya, and the male patron saint is Saint George. Saint George was a knight who killed a dragon to save a princess. And this dragon killed by Saint George 8 people. So when Antonio Gaudí made the Batlló house trying to represent the dragon killed by Saint George, he tried to make the skin of the dragon and then all the inside, the stomach of the dragon, where you will see the shape of the skulls and the bones of the people this dragon had eaten. Of course, you will need a lot of imagination to see that.
Esperemos que sea luz encendida.
More?
One.
How many? One more?
Two, one. One. Thank you.
¿Está encendido o qué?
Las luces de la casa de Dios, digo, para que vea algo.
Creo que sí.
Esperemos.
Creo que sí.
Esta hora es una hora rara, ¿sabes? Porque todavía están...
The Batlló house, we will see it in 1 minute more or less. It will be on the left hand side. We cannot stop the bus in front of the Batlló house. So we will, as you can see, there's a little bit of traffic. So we will drive very, very slowly so that you can see it better. But we will have just a few seconds to see it. The Batlló house, the property of the Batlló family. But all the houses in this neighborhood, they are really beautiful and monumental. Because in the early 20th century, this is the part of the city where the rich families lived. And there was a kind of competition to have the most beautiful house in town. All the families wanted the biggest, the most beautiful, and the most expensive house. The Batlló house, where you will see a very modern style, even nowadays it looks very modern, but was finished in 1907. It was finished 111 years ago.
Estas populares, ¿verdad?
¿Siente?
¿Ya?
No. Sí, sí.
Sí. Todos parecen iguales, ¿verdad?
Sí, claro.
So very soon, at the next corner on the left, in front of us, we will see the Batlló house. You will recognize the Batlló house because there's a tower with a cross on the top. And then we will see the roof with a greenish color that looks like the skin of the dragon. You can see now on the left with the lights. Yes, the way we have said, look at the shape of the schools and the balconies, the railings look like schools. Okay, we could stop in the traffic light, so we have a couple of minutes to see that better. So you can see that tower with the cross on the top. Antoni Gaudí was very religious, so in all his buildings there are crosses or religious symbols, even though this is not a church. Inside there was also a chapel. Then that roof, that wavy shape with the scales, yeah, that greenish roof, that's meant to look like the skin of the dragon. And then the facade with the waves, it's wavy. And you can see colors on the facade. It's all covered with mosaics made with broken tiles. Then all the railings, the balconies, you can see the shape of the skulls. And in a moment, when the traffic lights go green and we keep driving, you will see the bottom where there are some pillars that look like bones. You can even see the joints is there. So now on the left, you will see the bottom, those wavy shapes, the stone seems to be melting almost, and the pillars looking like bones. This one now is a museum. That's why you could see some people outside, yes. But this was an apartment building. All the buildings in this neighborhood, they belonged to just one family, one rich family. But that this rich family lived only on the second floor. We call it the main floor or the noble floor. Then on the upper floors, there were some smaller apartments that were rented to the working class people. And the attic, nowadays the attic is always the most expensive apartment. At that moment, nobody lived in the attic. It was used just as a laundry. But in this area, a lot of these old buildings, these former apartment buildings nowadays are hotels. Because renting the apartments here is quite expensive. And outside you will always see a lot of decorations. That always depended on how rich the family was.
Oye, ¿y este año? ¿Y ha pasado el día de cambiar la hora o no?
¿Qué va?
¿Y vamos a cambiar la hora o no? Porque me ha dicho gente que igual ya no. No sé, yo he escuchado...
Bueno, lo tenían ahí, pero todavía no habían dicho que sí ni que no.
¿Y cuándo es cuando el día de, debería cambiar la hora?
Pues no lo sé, yo para mí que la deben cambiar.
¿Eh? Yo también, para mí. Por eso ahora te estaba preguntando, porque digo, igual
pero,
es que no la han cambiado, ya está. Igual
final,
ya...
Al final no sé si la han dejado así ya o no sé.
Yo para mí que era a finales de septiembre, otros años, pero igual me equivoco.
Octubre,
igual finales de octubre.